Hey guys, what's good? It's your girl TJ. It's your girl TJ. I can say that in a minute, but anyway, we are back, okay? I'm here with Tinashe Hair, and we're going to get into it as you guys seen by the intro. We're doing like a rainbow, chalky, highlighted bob type wig. I don't even know what I'm going to name it, but like I said, she's from Tinashe. She's in the inches of 14, and she's a 6'13 blonde, okay? Okay, so this is actually the construction of the unit. She does have 3 combs in total, 2 on each side, 1 at the nape, and there's a drawstring. So we're gonna get into the coloring portion. I am using Temptations Red Storm color kit. Kiss was so nice to send me this kit. They sent me this last year, I believe, towards the end of last year, and I haven't got around to using it, but today we're gonna put these colors to work. I use every color in this collection, funky yellow. And y'all seen the other ones, Limelight and Flaming Orange. I used all these colors last year, but you know, they sent me a box, so we're gonna use it today. So I'm using high color as well, which I shouldn't use. It's for dark hair, but we're gonna use it today because I actually ran out of Kiss Express Jet Black. So we're gonna start off with our Got to Be Glue. We're gonna go ahead and secure our lace. This is gonna prevent your lace from staining. When you do the hand dyeing, it's easier to stain the lace versus you doing the watercolor method. And watercolor method, it trying to do this wig, since it would have been a disaster, so I had to. So now we're gonna go ahead and, well, off camera I did go ahead and section it. It's just easier to work in section versus just hair all in place. You don't know where you're going or doing. Pretty much, if you guys are new to my coloring series or my coloring videos in general, when I do wigs, I always use the back of the head to experiment because your girl don't know what she be doing sometimes. Okay, I was trying to make the vision in my head come to fruition, and yeah. I knew that if I had dark roots, once I rinsed it, it would have run, it's gonna run down the hair, okay? And it's gonna make the color a little bit darker than it actually is. And that's the whole look I was going for. I want that highlighted look, but I also wanted it chalky, and I didn't want it very, very vibrant because it's not spring yet. Wait, is it spring? No, that's Thursday, but it's not spring yet. But you know, I just wanted it slower on in. I didn't want to come full force with the colors, but yeah, so that's what I did. I took the back and tested it just to see what color it was. And I noticed it was going to give me like a navy blue or just a dark, dark, deep, rich blue. And that's what I was going for. And Kiss Express, you see this color that I'm blending together. That is Midnight Blue. But you got to be sure to blend your colors into your root color, because if you don't, you'll have some harsh lines. And you guys are going to see that because I started getting lazy and not blending it. So be sure to make sure you take your color up into your root color so it won't look very harsh and, you know, not well blended. Also, to keep the colors from, you know, like transferring to one another, just squeeze each section together. Y'all see I'm using this trash bag to wipe my hands off in between it, because ain't if I got time to keep changing gloves and just doing all that. I don't have time for that. So this is the easiest way I know how. Like I said, I'm just taking each section and just making them different colors. It's really no specific way or order I went into it. I didn't go in red, orange, yellow, green. I just pretty much free flow. Is that word? Yeah, free flowed with this unit. I just wanted like I said, a chalky, highlighted, rainbow look, if that makes sense. So now we're moving up to the center. In the center, y'all, I just started getting lazy, y'all. This wig, this vision is a very tedious process, and you have to, you know, you just have to really take your time and be patient with it, okay? But y'all know when you get to the middle section of your head, I just go bigger anyway, you know? So I started adding more colors and taking bigger sections because I think this whole process took me 2 hours just to get off dyeing, okay? In total, I let the unit sit to dry with, I didn't cover it in saran wrap or anything besides that bottom portion right there, but I let it like air dry for like 4 hours, then I washed it out. So, So now we're getting towards the top section of the unit, and we're just taking, Well, y'all, I ended up switching out this hair dye brush because it was just making a mess, okay? It wasn't small, and when you don't have a small hair dyeing brush for the root section, you can easily stain the lace, and you can just create a ruckus mess, which I did on the side of the lace. So I had to switch combs and take my time and part each section. As you guys can see, it is a tedious process, so be patient with it, okay? It's gonna come out, okay? It's gonna look crazy at first, but I'm telling you, at the end, it's gonna come together, and you're just gonna be so glad that you kept at it. So here, I don't know why I stopped doing the method I did in the back. I just started doing the whole section one color, which I should have just kept doing it each section different colors, but I didn't. So basically, I would take apart, I would split it in two, keep one side the dark root color, and then do the other side one solid color. But like I said, you live and you learn. Next time I want to go in and have these four sections that you see me, coloring all different colors. So I think I'm gonna try it next time. Just a little bit different. But I don't know if I already said this because, I don't know. But like I said, I always wanted a dark root because I know once you rinse it out, that dark color is going to fade into the lighter colors and it's going to make it a little bit deeper and richer. Okay, so I did go ahead and rinse her out. Like I stated before, left this bad boy in for 4 hours. I rinsed it out, let her condition for about 30 minutes, and I'm going to go ahead and blow dry her. I do put my BioSilk on her, and I do put in some leave-in milk detangler as well. Well, it's leave-in conditioner, but it's also a detangler. So we gonna go ahead and let her blow dry, and then we be back. So I went ahead and cut off the lace. If you guys are not new to my videos, you guys already know how to secure your lace. Y'all not new to this, okay? But if you're new, I have detailed videos on my channel how I do it in detail, in depth. But today we're just going to go ahead and, show you guys the little get down. I love the lace on this unit. It was very, very easy to blend in with my skin, honey. Let me just give you guys a quick rundown on this unit. This was the best 613 hair I ever had. Most 613 units that I do come across, they shed a lot. But this one, I was looking like, where is it shedding at? Sometimes I'd be like, this unit is too good. You know how units, sometimes you be thinking like they're too good to be true and you just waiting for something to happen. Well, nothing happened. So I was really, really impressed with, I don't even know if I had Tinashe 613 hair before. I probably did, but you girl don't remember, I do so many units, but y'all, I was just impressed with this unit. I didn't have any problems with this unit. Like I said, shedding, of course, but I didn't have any problems with the tangling either during the whole process. It took the colors amazingly, okay? Amazingly. I really, really loved how this creation turned out. You guys be the judge, let me know. Yes, it's looking a little dry here, but like I said, I was going for that chalky effect, y'all. If y'all... do y'all know, y'all get my drift where I was going? I was really going for that chalky effect. So really, really love working with this unit. Like I said, it was easy to melt down into this good old forehead. This hair was nice and soft and silky. Once I, like I said, I conditioned it, I washed it because of course I colored it. I didn't shampoo it though. I just like co-washed it with shampoo because after I rinsed the hair out with the color, I just conditioned it because of course, this is a semi-permanent hair dye, so if you wash it, of course, every time you wash it, it is going to, fade in color because it's semi-permanent. But sis, you guys let me know what you thought of this unit. I really think it turned out good. I really, really think it turned out very, very well. I love the density on this unit as well because, sis, it just looked very, very natural. Like I said, the roots ended up turning like some purple color, like a deep dark plum purple, but it's okay because I mixed my Kiss Jet black dye with the remaining high color that I had left. I feel like it worked out at the end of the day. I'm repeating myself, so let me go. So yeah, all details in regards to this hair will be listed in the description section below. You guys need your copies of a wig and go ahead and recreate the style. I need to start seeing y'all, you know, recreate this work, okay? Or do something, you know, another color if you want. You can do a solid color. You can do a watercolor method, whatever it is you want to do. So yeah, all information in regards to this hair will be listed down below. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Leave comments, let me know what you guys think, and yeah, until next time, you guys, see you later. Bye guys.